Welcome to Under SF Community First. My name is Connor Norris.
And I'm Christina Lander.
This season, we're highlighting local organizations that have a positive impact on the San Francisco community.
Last week, we enjoyed a super delicious and healthy rainbow salad with Jasmine Fenton and Fresh Approach.
And today, we're getting some fresh air with one of my personal favorite groups.
Mine too. The Golden Gate National Parks Conservancy is dedicated to conserving and preserving the parks for the future.
This organization oversees 30 national parks and uses their programs to educate and build a nature-loving community right here in SF.
From Alcatraz to Baker Beach, the people of San Francisco love the outdoors.
Our local parks are a great way to reconnect with nature in such an urban landscape. So how do we go about protecting it?
Well, luckily, we have a guest from the Conservancy to share some information with us.
We'll also discuss some hidden secrets about the parks, but you're just going to have to watch the rest of the episode to find those out.
Also, later on, we have a special performance from singer Mettzman and dancers Kassidy Friend and Nicole Maimon.
Now, I don't know about you, Christina, but my favorite thing about San Francisco is just spending time in the national parks.
I'm with you there, but let's check out why we're also drawn to visiting San Francisco's many parks.
There's a lot of times in which I feel like going to the national parks has connected me to people that I really care about. The best thing to do is just go to Ocean Beach, visit, watch the sunset over there.
My name is Drake. I come out to Ocean Beach all the time. I live a few blocks away. It's a real treat to be, you know, this close to the ocean.
A lot of the times when people are going to Ocean Beach or Baker Beach or the Presidio and Land's End, they don't realize that it is a national park.
My name is Emily. I'm at Ocean Beach right now with my dog, Nala. I love that you can be in the city, but you're also so close to great hikes and go to the beach and do a lot of outdoor activities.
Jeremy B. I'm a cancer survivor. This is part of my physical therapy every day. Just enjoying the beach, loving life.
Well, I'm Kelly Carter, and we are currently at the Golden Gate Bridge.
We're from Georgia, so it took us a while to get here.
Yeah.
Honestly, it just seems like such a beautiful city, and the architecture is very unique. And I didn't know what to expect, honestly,
yeah,
just from what we've seen on TV.
Smokey the Bear is not the mascot for National Park Service. I was under the impression he was, but he's not. I still love him, but the bison is the mascot.
This is awesome, too.
I really love this, the greenery. I didn't expect that. You don't really see that on TV, so that was a very unique perspective to be able to see how much beauty there is just around the bridge.
Every chance I get, I try to go to like San Rafael, do some hiking around there, Mount Tam, or Muir Woods. That's one of the reasons why I've lived out in San Francisco.
Seeing how much everyone appreciates San Francisco's national parks, it's understandable why people want to help preserve them.
Do you know what my favorite national park is?
I don't.
It is Fort Point.
Where is that?
Fort Point is underneath the Golden Gate Bridge, so you get this really crazy view of under the bridge and the rest of the bay.
That's really cool. I should check that out.
You should definitely check it out. Residents here are incredibly lucky to have so many parks made public to them. And we're just as lucky because we have Katie Fitzgerald here today to talk to us about it.
Katie is an academic intern with the Golden Gate National Parks Conservancy, and she's going to talk to us about what it's like working for the organization and ways that you can get involved.
And then we have a little treat for you all, but you'll have to stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest.
Still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise and be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Every time I hear the alarm bell go off in school, I think it's an air raid.
A lot of houses in our neighborhood have been destroyed. I like to close my ears and sing songs whenever the bombs come close.
I'm worried our new neighbors won't like us.
But I know it's all gonna be worth it. I just want my family to be safe. But these are not my
words.
These are not my words.
A story. Adopt at theshelterpetproject.org.
What are you, superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Norris. We're here at the Presidio Visitor Center opening celebration. You can probably hear and see it behind me. We're going to show you just a little bit of it.
Wisha! 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 Shania! 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 Shania!
My name is Michael Faw. I'm the accessibility and exhibit specialist for the Golden Gate National Recreation Area. I'm here because we're opening the new Presidio Visitor Center.
My name is Enoch Pacheco. My team is Lung Ma Sing Si Wei, Dragon Horse Line Dance Group. We just did a performance about an hour ago. It's a nice day, and we just came out for the community and to celebrate this milestone for the Presidio, really.
The goal of the Visitor Center is to orient people to the Presidio and to inspire them to travel other places.
My name is Sarah. This
Daniel.
Is Nolan. We just live on the border of the Presidio over here in San Francisco in the Lake District, and we frequent the Presidio a lot. It's one of our favorite places to hang out on the weekend, and we are really excited about the event today. We especially wanted to see the dancers and the performances. And then you were all excited about the Y-Bikes and the fire truck, right? What did you want to see today?
I want to see a performance.
The performance.
I'm Kimiko DePedro, and I'm the executive assistant here at Golden Gate National Recreation Area. Well, I think the community can benefit from national parks because it's a place where people can bond together. They can learn more about different habitats and animals that live in the national parks, what kinds of flora and fauna that we have, whether that's here in San Francisco or the Bay Area or anywhere in the country. But most importantly, it's their parks. This is a public place where they can go when things get a little bit too crazy and they want to go somewhere that's more serene and outdoors, and they want to dig deep into what the country's history is really all about. We're storytellers, and people find their personal connections with the Park Service.
My favorite park would have to be the Mysterious Presidio. At first, I thought it was just a place that had a bunch of rich houses and maybe a golf course. And then when I had my first shoot there doing a volunteer program, I saw that it had so much more to offer and all these beautiful views and places to go, trails to hike, and I just wanted to know more about it and figure out what my favorite spot could be.
I like working here because everybody in the office is passionate about making the national parks a more accessible, sustainable place that people can enjoy.
I think I really do appreciate working with the people who work for the parks. They're very passionate about what they do, they love what they do, and I think that just makes my job that much more enjoyable. Just anywhere where you work, when people are enjoying as much as you do, it makes it a lot easier.
I think in this day and age, everybody is so concerned about living a comfortable life, and we've become a little materialistic that we forget that one of the biggest de-stressors is just to disconnect from all the things that actually do stress us out. And what better way to do that than by connecting with nature?
That looked like such a cool event. I really liked the dragon dancers,
right,
and the
yeah.
drumming. I feel like if they came up right to my face, I'd be terrified, but from afar, that was really cool. And it was cool that they can do it in the park, you know?
Right.
Which proves that it really is for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to ask you, you told us what you do day by day. What is the most like interesting thing that has happened to you?
That's happened to me? Honestly, like every day is kind of something new. Just talking to different people, just interesting to hear everyone's stories and what brings them out to the parks, and I know, and just watching like nature as well. Like I saw a red-tailed hawk like go down and get like a little critter, and it was just amazing to see life happen.
Yeah, exactly. And what would you say is the best part about your job?
The best part, well, of course, being outside. I have amazing views, and just talking to people. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, everyone's in a good mood too because they're outside.
And so the Golden Gate National Parks Conservancy, that is the whole Golden Gate Park, right? Or is that just all over San Francisco?
Okay, so the parks, it's interesting. It goes from Marin mm-hmm. to San Francisco and down San Mateo.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow, that's really big.
We're actually the largest urban national park in the country.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so we're bigger than Central Park.
So what was like the coolest place you went to?
I think just being in Land's End is really interesting, and I really love it. John Muir Woods is amazing. If you haven't been, you should go see the redwoods.
Oh my God, I have.
Yeah.
I went on the Dipsy Trail hike.
Okay.
That killed me. But it was beautiful.
But it was beautiful, right?
It yeah. was really great. And I asked you a little about this earlier, but what do you think is the number one best way to raise awareness about national parks?
I honestly believe it should stem with kids. Like, I think we should be a little bit more on education about it and
yeah.
be able to reach out to different communities to get them more involved and realize that there are these beautiful lands that
yeah.
is essentially for everyone.
That's a really good point. Now, Katie, we're actually able to visit you working at Land's End.
Yeah.
I know I'm ready to see what you do every week. Ready to see, not do, you know, me and dirt don't mix that well. So let's watch.
My name's Katie, and I'm an academic intern with the Parks Conservancy. And today we are out at Land's End at the Lobos Dunes. And today we're focusing on pulling up Bromus deandris, which is a rip-cut broom grass. And the reason why we're pulling this up today is to make room for our native plants to reestablish an ecosystem in this area.
Today we are hosting Boy Scout troops so that we can have their help to remove this ripcut brome. It's a really invasive grass, and we're just trying to make sure that we can maintain the stability of the slope so that we can make sure that Land's End stays beautiful for everyone.
I think I love working for the National Park Service because my values are aligned with the mission of the National Park Service, protecting and preserving the natural and cultural resources of our country. I think the national parks are really important, and we need to protect them or else they won't be here for the next generation.
Coordinating volunteer groups, I saw how national parks brought the community together, from school groups to corporate groups, just seeing the diversity in the parks and how everybody took something away in a positive manner from the parks.
I'm grateful to have Land's End so accessible and within the city. My friends go there often and we go on little mini hikes, and the golden hour is amazing.
Not one person can single-handedly save the planet or save the environment, and I feel that these agencies, and especially the National Park Service, it's a community, it's more than just one person. There's a group of people who are working towards environmental protection, and what better way than to have it in our own backyard in San Francisco.
That's so cool to see what you guys do. You guys were working really hard out there. So I wanted to ask you, which national park is your favorite and why?
Let's see, I feel like I should say the San Francisco one just because I work there, but and it is amazing. But also Yellowstone has been one of my favorite national parks just because it has so much diversity with like geographically and like biologically, like with animals.
Where is Yellowstone?
It's over in Wyoming. Okay. And like touches Montana.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Land's End is amazing too. It has so much history that I didn't even know about. Like Sutro mm-hmm. Baths is a really interesting story too. If you haven't heard of it, you should definitely look it up.
Yeah, yeah. I haven't been there, but I've seen pictures of it and it looks really cool.
Yeah, like, it seems pretty amazing.
And I wanted to ask you, what is the most memorable moment you had at this organization?
Right. Like I said earlier, it's just every time just seems memorable. Like, it's such a great positive group that I work with too, and every day is amazing. And like that photo that, or not the photo, the video that we saw earlier, that was a group of Boy Scouts, and it was just so fun to see them like compete against who could like do the most weed bags, and just like them running around and like totally enjoying it and just asking so many questions. And I know, like,
that's,
like
that seems really cool because they might not think that they're actually helping the environment, but right. They are. Like, they just think they're playing games and stuff like that, but mm-hmm. they actually are doing a lot.
Yeah.
That's cool. And what is something that most people don't know about national parks?
Well, I think it's because, or what people don't really know is that it's for them. It's yeah. The parks are for the people, and it's accessible, and it's open to everyone. Doesn't matter who you are. It's, you know, a way to get in touch with nature and yourself.
That's really cool. Well, Katie, thank you so much for coming out today. And thank you for all the energy that you guys are putting into like saving our environment. So when we get back from the break, Mettzman, Kassidy's friend, and Nicole Maimon will be here. So we'll see you in a bit.
Don't wait. Communicate. Make your emergency plan today.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help,
smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
It's a short ride from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat, ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
Welcome back to Under SF Community First. Please enjoy Mettzman's original song, Wind Tide, accompanied by dancers Kassidy Friend and Nicole Maimon.
Lovers' whispers left long behind. I have been at sea for quite some time, praising the muse, drinking her wine. The sea is blue and the sky is fire red. Captain, there's something ahead. I don't wanna live, but I don't. Kept saying by camaraderie of men, when will we see land again? Thank you.
Well, that was absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for your time, Mettzman. Thank you to Nicole and Kassidy. Thank you guys so much.
And another thank you to Katie Fitzgerald and the Golden Gate National Parks Conservancy.
If you would like to learn more information on the Conservancy, visit their website and join their upcoming events, including Healthy Parks, Healthy People on April 1st and Create with Nature Earth Day Celebration on April 22nd.
And be sure to tune in to Under SF Community First next week to take a closer look at rebuilding SF.
Until next time, I'm Connor Norris.
And I'm Christina Lander.
Thank you for joining us here at Under SF Community First.